And here we go. Here we go. On this May 1st, the first day of May 2023, 6 o'clock straight up. That means it is time for Real Talk Memphis. And we are here and you are there. And I am very happy about it. Who am I? I'm your host, Chip Washington. It is good to be here on this beautiful evening. Man, the sun is shining out there and a little breeze blowing. And but yeah, it's been a very, very nice day. And it looks as if the week is going to be very nice as well. We're always glad you're with us, and we hope to have a good show for you tonight. Some good guests. I guess you could say it's ladies' night again this evening, because all my guests are females, and they all bring a lot to the conversation. But before we get too far into that, you're asking yourself how you get this fine piece of radio broadcasting. Well, you can do it in a number of ways. You can do it, of course, on the radio, 91.7 on your FM dial, WYXR. We are on the air right now. You can also catch us on the WYXR app, the TuneIn app, Facebook Live. I think, are we on Facebook Live? Can we go? Okay. Of course, once the show is posted after tomorrow, you will be able to find us on YouTube, if that's your desire. And, of course, wherever you get your podcast. So we're fired up and ready to go on this lovely evening. And, you know, there's always a lot going on in our city and in our county. Of course, Beale Street Music Festival is coming up in a few days, and I'm sure that there are many of you out there who are excited about it and ready to get out there and enjoy yourself. All I can say is on the Monday before the Friday, please be careful out there, because there's always a lot going on. We had a shooting on Beale Street yesterday that injured a couple of people. You know, just be mindful. I'm sure there'll be plenty of security out there. And I want you to go, if that's what you do, and have a great time, enjoy yourself. But just watch out, pay attention to what's going on out there, because I would like to keep you safe. In terms of our guests tonight, we think we have three good ones. Many of you have been keeping up with what is going on, or at this point not going on, with the new school superintendent search. Well, a lot of us have questions, and of course, that would be yours truly. We're going to have school board member Stephanie Love will join us in just a few minutes to talk a little bit about the process, how it's going and where it's going from here. Of course, it's been paused right now until they can sort some things out, and hopefully she'll be able to chat with us about that. A little bit later on, we will be talking with State Senator Ramesh Akberry, and she will be joining us to talk about the legislative session just ended. And, you know, it was interesting on a lot of different levels, of course, and we will get her take on what happened with the two Justins, of course, and gun control legislation, and a lot of other things that are happening. So we'll look forward to that conversation. And a little bit later on, we're going to be speaking with a woman by the name of Alicia Denton. And Alicia is a victims services supervisor for the MPD, Memphis Police Department. When law enforcement officers have to make the grim notification to family members that a loved one has been killed, someone has to pay attention and provide answers and comfort to the families. This is a unique thing that they have here, where she and some of her folks actually accompany law enforcement officers to homicide scenes to tend to the family members, those left behind when traumatic events like this ensue. So looking forward to having a very, very important conversation with her a bit later on. So glad you're here. And you know, what we always do at this time of the show is to celebrate your trip around the sun. Now, as I said, we are in a new month. There are a lot of May babies out here to celebrate. So I hope that you guys, between now and the end of the month, will chime in and let us shout you out in the way we're accustomed to doing so. But I can't, there's a lot of birthdays today, as a matter of fact, but I can't even get to this list until I say, hit it, Brent.
Happy birthday to you.
Happy birthday. Happy birthdays going out to the following folks. Sandeep Pennikar is celebrating his birthday today, as is LaVon Atkins. Tina Marie Ross celebrating today. Christy Kane. Ronnie M. Matthews celebrating her birthday today. Elmira Collins, happy birthday to you. Sandra Cheney. Daryl Anderson. Judge Booker celebrating today. Pam Flowers, it's happy birthday to you. Janice Edwards is celebrating today. And Annette McBride Graves is celebrating today. Oh, and by the way, very special happy birthday to our good friend Wanda Halbert, Shelby County Clerk, celebrating her birthday today. So to each and every, before I do it, Lola, doesn't you have a birthday today? Okay, Lola's birthdayed out. Nicole, you don't have a birthday? Okay. So no birthdays from the gallery today, but from all of us here at Real Talk Memphis, enjoy your day. We hope you've had a wonderful day and that it's been filled with fun and laughter. And we hope to be back here next year to celebrate your next trip around the sun. Thank you, Bryn. So I'm keeping my eye on the screen here because we do have a guest that will be checking in just a few minutes. But in terms of news and notes, Let me back up. We did the birthdays. There were a couple of deaths to talk about since we last saw each other. One, of course, Harry Belafonte, great man, not only a wonderful performer, but an activist, you know, was very influential in the movement, especially during Dr. King's time. He died at the age of 93 last week. And much closer to home, the longtime band director at Whitehaven High School transitioned yesterday. And, you know, many people, of course, very shocked by that. This happened in Atlanta, apparently, and we don't know the cause, but we do know that that he passed away. And very, very popular. If you've ever heard Whitehaven's band, they were really, really tremendous. So our hearts and our prayers and our thoughts go out to all of those who knew Andre Newsom. He was the band leader at Whitehaven High School for over 15 years. So, you know, again, just a big loss for that school and for our community. And we pray for all of those who are affected. And may his memory always be a blessing. In terms of this mayoral election that is coming up in just a scant few months, we're still having conversation as to who is eligible and who is not. Eligibility requirements in terms of your residency, living in the city. Now, back in the day, it was always you had to be in the city for 5 years in order to be elected mayor of Memphis. Well, there was a debate a couple of years ago where they dropped the five-year residency requirement to 1 year. This has been going back and forth now, and it's in court here locally, of course. Floyd Bonner and Van Turner have filed lawsuits against the Shelby County Election Commission. Well, today in court, Jennifer Sink, who is the city attorney, said that the five-year residency rule, she changed her mind actually, for running for mayor is still in effect. This means that, of course, Floyd Bonner, Van Turner and Willie Harrington, as of now, are out of the race. They can't run because they all, you know, moved or have been living outside of the city of Memphis. I think that's a silly, this whole five-year deal is silly. But in any event, it has not been cleared up. The election is like 3 months away. And so we're still sitting around here waiting to figure out exactly what happened, you know, and because of the lawsuits and everything else going on in reference to this particular situation. So stay tuned to this because we still have, 10, 11, 12 people in the race. But a lot of people can't even get started because of the fact that there's a residential requirement issue. And of course, the three names that I mentioned are pretty high on that list in terms of, you know, popularity and, you know, name recognition and everything else. So all I can say is stay tuned. The Grizzlies season is over, and they got spanked in Los Angeles on Friday night. Actually, it was a beatdown. It was 40 points. They lost by 40 points. And there's really no other way to sugarcoat that other than to say it was a beatdown. Now, they are a bit on the young side. They are a bit immature. They do have a lot of growing up to do. And more importantly, they need to stop talking and start playing. Now, Dylan Brooks, it is my prediction, has played his last game as a Grizzly. I don't believe that he's going to change his ways. He was very unimpressive. And as LeBron said, if there is a fight between a grizzly bear and a regular bear, you know, he said, help the grizzly because I'm coming. So the next round will be the Lakers versus Golden State, which should be a rather entertaining series. Did you see Steph Curry drop 50 points yesterday against Sacramento? That's a bad little fella right there. We will stop it there, and we will take our first break of the broadcast. And when we come back, we will begin things waiting on Stephanie Love, school board member, to give us a call, check in with us. In the meantime, I'm glad you checked in with us. This is Real Talk Memphis for this Monday evening. I am Chip. You know who you are. We'll take one quick break, and we will be right back.
If you like Real Talk, here's a way you can get involved. Do you have a show topic idea or suggestion? Want to be considered a guest or have a guest idea? Then send Chip a message on his Real Talk show page and you can be a part of the Real Talk experience. So as he always says, go out and tell somebody. We'll be right back.
WYXR is supported by Minglewood Hall, hosting reggae musician Steel Pulse on June 8th and Stephen Marley on July 18th. More information at MinglewoodHallMemphis.com. WYXR is supported by the Museum of Science and History, presenting Laser Live, which brings live music and laser light effects together for a live concert series in the Mosh AutoZone Dome at the Sharp Planetarium. Laser Live begins May 13th with Hope Claiborne and Soul Scrimmage. More information at MoshMemphis.com.
WYXR Stereo Sessions presented by Mempho returns this month on Wednesday, May 10th at the Memphis Listening Lab as we celebrate The Clear's 1997 self-titled debut. The free listening event finds WYXR host and former member of Sonic Youth, Steve Shelley, along with music writer Andrea Lau, as they interview Clear's bandmates Alicia Trout and Brad Pounders. The duo will talk about the album's impact on Memphis music and their amazing post-punk synth-pop sound. You can RSVP for the event at stereosessions.wyxr.org. This stereo session is brought to you by Via Productions, Crosstown Brewing Company, Shangri-La Records, and Farmer.
Do you want to place your company in front of Memphis cultural consumers and influencers? How about interacting with them in a meaningful way? WYXR's second annual stereo sessions at the Memphis Listening Lab is back. We are looking for sponsors to support WYXR's exploration of unsung albums from the musical history of Memphis. For more information, email us at sponsorships@wyxr.org.
WYXR is supported by the On Stage at the Halloran Center 2022-2023 season, which continues in downtown Memphis. Experience live entertainment with music, magic, and more, including the return of Orchestra Unplugged and the Songwriter Series events. More information and the full lineup at orpheum-memphis.com/onstage.
WYXR's 2023 Stereo Sessions with the Clears is supported by Farm Burger. Offering custom grass-fed burgers, seasonal salads, and more, Farm Burger takes pride in their grass-fed beef and partners with local farms such as Home Place Pastures, Bonnie Blue Farm, and Marmalou Farms. Farm Burger is your neighborhood grass-fed burger joint, located in the East Atrium of Crosstown Concourse. More information at farmburger.com.
Get Real Talk on the TuneIn mobile app under WYXR, and he's now streaming live on Facebook. And you can also catch a rebroadcast on YouTube. Just put WYXR in the search box and hit subscribe. Now back to more Real Talk with Chip Washington.
And welcome back to Real Talk Memphis on this Monday evening. Chip with you. Very happy to have you with us as well. We were talking at the top of the show about current issue with the selection of a new superintendent for the Memphis and Shelby County Schools, and we wanted to get a little clarity in reference to that. So we've invited one of the school board members to join us this evening. She is Stephanie Love. Stephanie, are you there?
Yes.
Well, good evening. How are you tonight?
Fine.
Very, very good. So, well, thanks for coming on the show. I really appreciate it. I know it has been a challenging time in reference to the selection of a new superintendent. How would you categorize the way things are going to this point?
We had some hiccups. But who doesn't?
Right, exactly.
The most important thing is we have to get to the children. We have to get to the Northern Star, and that is the children.
Well, that is absolutely the priority in terms of this. Now, there's been a pause in the process. Can you say at this particular point in time when you all are going to reconvene? You're going on a retreat. Am I correct in that?
Yes. Before the retreat, I have been the option of chairing the committee along with Joyce Coleman. And we are doing a committee meeting May 9th.
Okay.
To get questions from each and every board member about the superintendent search. Clarity comes from everyone being involved. Everyone is going to have their questions answered in a timely manner, and that is going to be the focus on the retreats on next week.
Okay, so you're at the stage now where all of you are going to get together. Everyone is going to have questions that they need to be answered as the process continues moving forward. Are there still three finalists at this point, Stephanie?
No, I don't know that for say. The board wants to decide to put other candidates in there. It is their free will. I don't know for say.
Do you have a preference in terms of that? Would you like to see additional candidates involved, or where are you personally in this process?
I just want the superintendent search to be over.
Okay.
And get back to the business of educating our children.
Are you satisfied in reference to the community input? I know, initially there were some community meetings involving them and giving them a chance to give their input into this. Do you think that the community has been as involved as you would have liked them to be?
No, I think that community involvement is of the utmost importance, but we didn't see a lot of community involvement. We have over 100,000 students,
yes,
and families,
mm-hmm,
and teachers and principals and support staff. I didn't see that at the meetings.
So
everyone has their own life to sort out. But I would like to see more community support.
Yeah, I think it is very important, especially when you're selecting such an important position. And more importantly, what you said at the outset, Stephanie, in reference to all the board members seem to be on the same page. You know, we've seen, you know, some excerpts from, you know, some meetings here recently where different ones had different questions and different thought processes about this particular situation. So it really is important that as a team, as a unit, as a board, you are all on the same page, correct?
Very important that we stay on the same page. We don't have to agree or disagree with everything anybody puts out. We are all working together for the common good.
If you're just joining us, ladies and gentlemen, we're speaking with school board member Stephanie Love, and we are talking about the selection process involving a new superintendent of education. Stephanie, let me ask you this question. Does it bother you or impact you or influence you one way or the other that currently, from what we know currently, there are three members, finalists, and that two of them are from the Memphis and Shelby County School District?
No. That doesn't bother me.
Okay. So because, you know, in terms of the search committee, you know, I guess they were tasked to search all over the country for candidates. And I do know that the additional candidate of the three is from out of state, correct?
We have some great candidates here. I am biased to selecting someone from out of state. The qualifications may be good. Memphis is on its own. Memphis has its own culture, mm-hmm, own problems,
mm-hmm,
and not saying that an outsider can be good. Give everyone a chance. We have a lot of talent based in Shelby County Schools.
Right. Well, it sounds, again, so once again, it sounds as if, you know, for what you said earlier, you all are going to get together as a board and you all are going to, you know, have your questions together and try to get everything uniform before then you're going to have a retreat. And then you're going to figure out, are you going to figure out, Stephanie, at the retreat, hopefully, as to when you will resume the process of the selection?
Yes.
Okay, all right.
Everything will be started out at the retreat. That is the reason we are having it.
Well, listen, I want to thank you for taking some time to come on the show tonight to address the issue. We hadn't heard a lot about this, from you, but it seems like you're very clear in your focus and direction. And as you said earlier, you just want to pick the best candidate for the position, correct?
Near and far.
Near.
Let me rephrase that. A superintendent near and far who is the best suitable for our district moving upwards. I don't I'm very biased to Memphis residents receiving a chance, but it is not the only thing I am biased about. May the best man or woman win.
There you go. That's perfect. That's a great way to leave this. Stephanie Love, thank you so much for coming on the show. I really appreciate it. And best of luck down the road, okay?
Yes. Thank you.
All right. You're welcome. Stephanie Love, ladies and gentlemen, Memphis and Shelby County School Board member, giving us her thoughts and opinions as she sort of leading the team here. The next step is for the commissioner, for all the school board members to get together and talk about how they want to move forward in this direction. And then they're going to have a retreat. No date as of yet, but when they come out of the retreat, per Stephanie, they're going to have a pretty good direction in terms of how they move forward, which way they move forward. And as she said, it doesn't matter if you're local or you're out of state. May the best person and the most qualified person be selected. And that is all we want. Stephanie Love, thank you so much for coming on the show. We're going to take another break. And when we come back, we're going to turn our attention to state politics, and we're going to talk to our good friend, State Senator Ramesh Akberry. This is Real Talk Memphis. I'm Chip. Don't go away. We'll be right back.
If you like Real Talk, here's a way you can get involved. Do you have a show topic idea or suggestion? Want to be considered a guest or have a guest idea? Then send Chip a message on his Real Talk show page and you can be a part of the Real Talk experience. So as he always says, go out and tell somebody. We'll be right back.
Shangri-La Records proudly supports WYXR. They offer a selection of vinyl, CDs, books, and more. Shangri-La has operated in the Memphis area for over three decades, and they are located at 1916 Madison Avenue in Midtown. They're open 7 days a week. More information at shangri.com.
River Series is a proud sponsor of WYXR. The series continues May 13th with Mark Eggers Stewart and Aaron James, and May 20th with Chapel Hill, North Carolina Spider Bags, and a tribute to Memphis' Flat Tire Rockers Limes. Doors at 4 p.m. for both shows. Tickets and more information at riverseries.org.
At WYXR, we are committed to uplifting local organizations and businesses who are making an impact in Memphis. If you are looking for ways to spread the word about your business on air and want to support WYXR at the same time, email us at sponsorships@wyxr.org.
Did you know you could donate your vehicle and support WYXR at the same time? We offer free pickup and it's tax deductible. Go to cars.wyxr.org to donate your car today.
Church Health's Memphis Plan continues its decades-long commitment to serving local musicians with comprehensive health care and also tailors its focus to small business owners and the self-employed. Healthcare through the Memphis Plan provides care in Memphis for Memphians. Related services include preventative health, optometry, dental care, and more. More information regarding availability at memphisplan.org or at 901-272-PLAN.
Get Real Talk on the TuneIn mobile app under WYXR, and he's now streaming live on Facebook. And you can also catch a rebroadcast on YouTube. Just put WYXR in the search box and hit subscribe. Now back to more Real Talk with Chip Washington.
Welcome back to Real Talk Memphis on this Monday evening. Chip Washington with you. Very happy to have you along for the ride. We are waiting for our next guest, which is supposed to be State Senator Ramesh Akberry. And I haven't seen her yet in the queue. So hopefully she will be joining us momentarily. Terrily, I wanted to kind of go back to the conversation we just had, if you're joining us, with Stephanie Love, who is a school board member, and of course, talking a bit about the process now. For many of us, it has been challenging, to say the least. It was interesting to hear her say that she did not see the community input. Initially they were asking for anyone who was interested. They had community meetings in several locations in and around the city for you to weigh in on what you would like to see in a new superintendent and the whole nine yards. But she said that they didn't see as much community input, as possible. Now, these are your children who are attending the school. We want our children to get the best education that they can possibly get. We need a leader to be able to do that. There were several individuals that were, I think they went through a process. I can't remember how many they had initially apply. But then it got whittled down to 24. Then it got whittled down to 12. And then from 12, they picked the three or four candidates that they thought should be the finalists in this. Two of those individuals, the finalists initially dropped out. One of them took a position in another state, and the other one dropped out because they put a pause in the process here. Again, they're taking their time as a board. They're trying to figure things out, getting with this search company, trying to find the best candidates possible to this process. So, we'll have to, follow it very closely and see what happens. In the meantime, if any of you know Ramesh Ackberry, tell her we're waiting for her here on Real Talk Memphis. Sometimes, huh? She had a family emergency? Oh, okay. All right. Well, anyway, we just heard that, and I'm sorry to hear that. We just heard that she had a family emergency, and she will not be joining us this evening. So we carry on. This is live radio, ladies and gentlemen, and we will continue moving forward. We do have a guest that I'm going to speak to in a few minutes. Her name is Alicia Denton, and Alicia is a victim services supervisor for the MPD. Say there's a crime scene, a homicide has been committed. Law enforcement will respond to the scene, their first job is, of course, to investigate the circumstances of what happened. Meantime, family members who are involved in this, whose loved one may be a part of this, are left in shock and sadness and really don't know how to respond to this. Law enforcement is not good at responding to the victim's families. That's why her particular area, victim services, is important. And a lot of times they actually go to the scene of a homicide with homicide detectives, so the homicide detectives can begin the investigation process while she tends to the family members. Gives them comfort, provides them, someone to talk to, because people are in shock in situations like this. It's very, very difficult. And she's going to kind of explain that to us exactly how long it's been in effect, why it's so important, and what this is all about. I was talking at the beginning of the show about the mayoral election that will be coming our way in just a very few months. And first of all, there's 12 or 13 candidates involved in this, and it really doesn't seem like there's a lot of attention being paid to this right now. Time is flying. This is May. And I mean, literally in just 2-3 months, you'll be going to the polls to pick the new leader of this city. And you really don't seem to be all that interested. They've had several meet and greets. They've had straw polls that have occurred. The same four or five candidates may show up. In case you did not hear, the city attorney in this ever-continuing saga of do you have to be a resident 5 years before you can run for office, or can you be a resident for 1 year and run for the office of mayor? Well, the city attorney, in kind of a shocking voice this morning, said that as far as she's concerned, the 5 year qualifying time is still in effect. In other words, you have to live in the city for 5 years before you can run for office. Now, my question has always been, does it matter to you as someone who is a member of the voting contingent? Does it bother you that, I mean, is 5 years too long? I mean, is a year long enough? I mean, how long is too long? That really is the conversation that a lot of you are going to have to think about as Election Day is right around the corner. That is just one of many things that we are dealing with in our city. And every question that they when they have these little open conferences with these political folks who are running for office, the first question they ask is, what are you going to do about crime? Can a mayor actually do something about crime? That's another good question. So listen, we're going to take another break. And when we come back, we should have our next guest to be joining us. This is the Monday edition of Real Talk Memphis. We heard just a few minutes ago that Ramesh had a family emergency and she would not be able to make it tonight. Those things happen. But we'll take a break and we will be back in just a few minutes. You come back with us.
If you like Real Talk, here's a way you can get involved. Do you have a show topic idea or suggestion? Want to be considered a guest or have a guest idea? Then send Chip a message on his Real Talk show page and you can be a part of the Real Talk experience. So as he always says, go out and tell somebody. We'll be right back.
You're listening. But are you in the know? The WYXR weekly newsletter is the best source for keeping up with events at WYXR, whether they are happening on our airwaves, behind the scenes, or out in the community. Log on to newsletter.wyxr.org to sign up for our mailing list and keep yourself in the loop.
WYXR doesn't go to sleep at night. We keep the music moving. Memphis music, that is. When our DJs clock out, our automation clocks in with music right from our community. Produced, performed, and written by Memphians, or in Memphis. Some are hits, and some are rarely heard, but they all tell the story of one of the world's greatest music cities. Visit WYXR.org for playlist and scheduling information. Email submissions at WYXR.org to let us hear your Memphis music. We may just play it.
WYXR is community radio, so why not help us spread our sound through the community? Be a part of our growth by sharing our station and our mobile app with a friend. Visit us at WYXR_Memphis on social and tag your closest pals. Let someone you love know about 91.7 FM. It's easy. Our sound is made just for you, so let's make it louder.
Can't find your radio? Maybe you're out of town and missing that Memphis feeling? WYXR can go with you wherever you travel with our mobile app for Android and Apple. Listen live or explore our archive and keep up to date with notifications. Download in your mobile app store by searching WYXR radio app or visit WYXR.org for more information.
Get Real Talk on the TuneIn mobile app under WYXR, and he's now streaming live on Facebook. And you can also catch a rebroadcast on YouTube. Just put WYXR in the search box and hit subscribe. Now back to more Real Talk with Chip Washington.
And welcome back to Real Talk Memphis on this beautiful May 1st evening in the city. Chip here with you, and of course, as we were talking earlier in the show, about our next guest. And I find this to be unique, but so totally necessary, in particular with all the homicides that we have seen in our city. Unfortunately, the response to those by law enforcement authorities is only one part of the total equation, because what is left is a family who is in shock, who is who's grieving what happened, and wanting questions answered. So my next guest is someone who does that, and I'm very happy to have her on the show. Her name is Alicia Denton, and she is a victim services supervisor for the Memphis Police Department. And Alicia, it's good to see you. Welcome to Real Talk.
Thank you. I'm glad to be here with you today. Thank you for having me.
Yes, indeed. So basically, I don't know if I explained it right or not, but if I didn't, you know, kind of clarify what your duties are in reference to what you do. Now, you're a counselor too by trade. Am I correct in that?
Yes, you are correct, Chip. Yes, absolutely, I am. And you're absolutely right. This is a grant-funded program from the Office of Victims of Crime that MPD was awarded in 2019. And then I was hired in 2020 to come aboard to provide services or to develop this program basically from scratch, Chip. So there was not a blueprint or anything. So building it from scratch and providing services for secondary victims of homicide. And in what that looks like basically is we participate in the death notification along with the homicide investigators, as well as providing the wraparound services for those victims' families, as well as witnesses. And those wraparound services could look like anything from counseling, therapy, group sessions, to helping them complete what's called victims' compensation, which is a reimbursement fund for funeral and burial expenses.
How, is there an obvious answer to this question, but how important is you being on the scene in such terrible circumstances along with the MPD, because they clearly have a job to do in terms of the investigative side, and they really don't know how to talk to victims because, you know, their focus is trying to figure out exactly what and why happened. But how important is it and how valuable is it for you to be at these scenes with the investigators of these crimes?
Well, on the scene, there's a lot of moving parts. And sometimes you can have family members to be on the scene and witnesses, families, friends, colleagues. And with us being a part being there, what it helps with the investigators, they can focus more on the investigative side of the cases. They can focus on their investigations while we're there to offer comfort and provide immediate crisis intervention for the family members. So that kind of takes that load, if you will, off the investigators, and we're there to be with the families and assist in that process.
Yeah, I was gonna say, I think you were telling me that because of the number of situations like this, homicides like this, you actually have a bit of a staff now to be able to help you in terms of what you do, correct?
Yes, I do. I'm so thankful because I started as a team of one. Wow. And trying to navigate everything all on my own. And then in 2021 and 2022, respectfully, I was able to hire two victim specialists to bring them aboard to provide direct services to the families. So I'm so thankful to have Camille and Tara here with me in this unit.
This is, I don't know if you know or not, but this just seems like such a, sort of completes the component, because this is a very, there's no way around it. This is a very tragic set of circumstances that you see, you know, and you have to take that grief and that emotion and everything that goes along with this and try to process it and try to be able to help them, guide them through it. How difficult a process is that for you and your staff sometimes? I'm sure as human beings, it would have to be, I would imagine.
Well, you know, I wouldn't say it's a difficult process. And, you know, I say this, and I'm going to quote Camille, our victim specialist. She said, you know what, I think we're just built for this. You know, we have these specialized skill sets and being a trained counselor and kind of knowing. And I've worked in trauma without telling my age for almost 20 something, probably 25 years.
Okay. All right. I like that. Go ahead.
So for quite a while, and no one expects such a thing as this, you know, of losing a loved one in such a tragic manner. But what we do, we know that it's our job, because you have to have what I call the thing, Chip. And you're like, what is the thing? That's something that can't be taught. It's genuine. It's empathy. It's having a heart for human beings. And we're working with families of all walks of life. So we have a no judgment zone here. So we're tailoring the emotional and personal needs that they need at that time.
And you know, and you said something very important, and being built for this, and really having had a heart for other people, or having to have a heart for other people, you know, that sort of takes me to, you know, when I know people aren't, this is a very emotional situation and a very emotional moment in time for people. But even during those times of grief and anger and distress, even victims know when a person is being sincere, you know, in terms of their, you know, what you do, or in terms of your caring component, and really, you know, how you help them through this process. I think even they understand when someone is being sincere in this process. Am I correct in that?
Absolutely, they do. And in fact, just to speak to that, we have families, and it's not about we appreciate the thank yous and the gratitude, we love that, but we're here to make a difference. We're here to help them at one of the probably worst days of their lives. Mm-hmm. And no day is the same here. You know, I've been asking, you know, what strategies do you use based on the situation? I said, well, it just depends. We have to be the tree that bends and be flexible, because there could be one family member, we've just notified them of the death of a loved one, and they're completely silent. They're numb. We just sit there in that moment. It could be 20 minutes to an hour, but that's what that family needs at that time. Then we have some that want to cry and hug you. So it just all depends. So we're there just to be in that moment with them. That's important, being in the moment with them, not having any distractions of what's going on around us, even on the scene, because like I said, there's lots of moving parts. So we have to be very in tune to the family and what their needs are at that time.
Yeah, I would say so. But you know, there's always a self-care component, and whenever I talk to somebody that does what you do, you know, especially dealing with the human emotion of others, I often wonder how you all, even though you're built for this, and even though you've been trained for this, you're still human beings. And I mean, all of you are still human beings. You're not robots, and you're not mm-hmm. androids. You know, I mean, how do you process this sometimes? You have to go home and try to live your life, but how do you all help yourselves in terms of dealing with what you deal with on a daily basis?
Yeah, and you're absolutely right. We are human as well, and we're dealing with some really heavy stuff on a day-to-day basis. And it's important, and I emphasize that to my team of self-care. You know, and even if I notice, I said, okay, you know what, it's time for you to tap out. we can handle this. You know, you go home early today, or you do something with your family. So for me, I rely, Chip, heavily on my faith, and I stay grounded. Also, I'm a baker, so I love baking and making chocolate. So those are my
chocolate. Chocolate always works, doesn't it? Chocolate.
Absolutely. Chocolate is the answer to it all, if you let me tell it.
Well, you know, I really do you know, Alicia, do you know if there are many law enforcement agencies nationwide that have areas of need such as this one here in Memphis?
Yes, actually, in 2019, there were other law enforcement-based victim services programs that were initiated along with us here in Memphis, from Tulsa to Louisville to Houston to Chicago. And what's interesting, there's probably approximately maybe 22 we started out, and then some of them have been absorbed by their particular departments, and some of them are still on grants like us. But the interesting thing is not everybody starts with the same victimization per se. Mm-hmm. For example, we only handle homicides. There are other law enforcement based agencies like I am that they started in sex crimes or DV or others. It depends on what was the most pressing in their city and their state.
Wow. Well, hats off to what you do. This really is God's work. It truly is. Mm-hmm. I think you all are angels in terms of what you do, and you're helping so many people, more people than you'll ever know. And I really thank you for coming on the show tonight. Thank you for talking with us about this, and more importantly, thank you for what you do. You know, for so many who are in need during very desperate times.
Thank you for having me. I really appreciate it. Thank
All right. You. You're welcome. You're very welcome. Alicia Denton, ladies and gentlemen, and again, a victim service supervisor for the Memphis Police Department. And they're the ones that go out and help folks who are dealing with life situations that they never thought that they would ever deal with ever. And we're very happy that she decided to come on the show tonight and chat with you. So I have a couple of minutes left here. Well, a few minutes left. One of our guests had to pull out this evening, but that's okay because, life happens. I'm sitting here and I'm reading some of the... Well, first of all, let me acknowledge some of the Facebook folks that are online here. I see my little brother Mandrell McLaughlin is checking us out tonight. My brother Michael Washington is checking in from Los Angeles, California. Brett Thompson, Melvin Jones, the Melvin Cooking Jones, ladies and gentlemen, checking us out. Patricia A. Rogers, Jackie Hill, what's going on? Anyway, Jackie and I go way back. Sarah Gum, Cousin Lou Cheshire is checking us out this evening as well. He is also a West Coast guy. And thank you all for wherever you are, whoever you are, and however you catch us. Truly appreciate you being a part of the program. So as I was saying earlier, Beale Street Music Festival in just a few more days. I'm sure that law enforcement will be working overtime. I'm trying to understand for the Blues Festival, which will be in Handy Park, they are going to be wanding you, and they are going to be, there's going to be security. There's going to be a lot of security there. There was an incident that happened at Beale Street yesterday afternoon in front of Alfred's out there. A couple of folks got shot. So the antennas are up. The antennas will be up. So if you're thinking about mischief, don't do that because you might not fare too well, in terms of that. For those of you who watch television on a fairly regular basis, there's a program on called 911 with Angela Bassett and a few other folks there. Well, apparently Fox has canceled 911, but Nicole is Nicole just in shock over here. They canceled it, but it was saved by another network. So 911 can be found now on ABC in the fall. So after six seasons, Fox announced today that they were canceling the show. But, ABC came in and picked it up for season seven. So you okay about that? Yeah.
What about
Lone Star?
Yeah, the other one. It's two of them.
No. The 911, the original one with Angela Bassett, that's the one that got canceled. But picked up. Which one?
That's the good one.
Which one?
The one with Angel
Bassett. Okay. Well, that's the one that got that's the one that got picked up. You know, we'll get you through it. Anyway. So listen, we're gonna get out of here tonight and try to enjoy another hour of sunlight. But as for you, I really appreciate you all checking us out tonight, as always. And as Bren plays us out, I would just like to continually thank you. I don't ever take what we do here for granted. I don't. Because it's not about me, it's about the guests, and it's about you. And if you enjoy what we do, we're going to keep doing it. But we can't keep doing it unless you continue to like, follow, share, and support this show. Follow Real Talk Memphis. Follow me. Follow my page if you're so inclined. And all I ask is if you've never checked this show out, give us a shot. And either you like it or you don't. But I bet you do like it in the end. So thank you. And if the Lord says so, we will be back here next week, same time, same studio, same chair, and I try to do it just a little bit better. So for Nicole, for Lola, for Bren, I'm Chip, and we are out. You have a safe week. We'll talk to you next Monday.